A quick recap to our last video, in which we have used an aluminium sheet to construct the structure of our refrigerator, where we placed the module at required places and completed the refrigerator, but without the smart technologies. This device has some problems, which are as follows. Firstly, it consumes very high energy, which is almost 156 watt. For a device like this, it is quite a lot of power. Secondly, we cannot control the internal temperature as per our usage. So as to overcome this problem and to use the device in our own way, we have designed a simple circuit and then converted the same into PCB and sent it to PCBWay. After a few days, we have got our PCBs, and we have to say the quality of the PCBs are excellent. Then we have arranged all the required components of the PCB and started soldering. Then we have soldered thick wires into the power lines because of the fact that a Peltier module can draw up to 15 ampere of current and a PCB cannot handle that much current. The touchscreen display comes in shield forms. So first, I have removed all the connectors and then soldered flexible cables for the required pins. In another side, we have connected a female header so that we can easily connect and disconnect the display from the PCB. Lastly, we have added a dressable LED for aesthetics and added LM35 to sense the internal temperature. As the PCB work is now complete, we have written few lines of code to control the system and uploaded it into the Arduino. Then I have assembled the rest of the system. Now our smart fridge is ready. We can control everything using this 2.4 inch touchscreen panel. Click here to turn on the device. Here you can see the current temperature of the refrigerator, and we can set the desired temperature using these two arrows. Suppose the temperature is 12 degrees Celsius. So, if the inside temperature falls to 15 degrees Celsius, one module will shut down. And if the temperature falls below the desired temperature, that is 12 degrees Celsius, then both the module will shut down. Moreover, when the temperature rises again, then only one module will do the initial job. Therefore, this is efficient for energy consumptions. Using the toggle button, we can also change the color of the internal lights. Isn't it cool? We are giving away 2 Peltier modules and SMPS to 2 of our lucky subscribers. To participate in the giveaway, leave a comment and share it with your friends. Everything about the project is available in our Patreon page, where your small support can help our innovative experiments. So that's it for now. See you in the next video. Till then, goodbye.